So due to flexibility, what I was discussing, that what is flexibility due to unit force, how much will be my displacement? Okay, wedge method, because due to unit force, how much displacement is occurring, that is my account. And whenever all about force, with the, so this is what I told you, this is the displacement. Displacement or generalized displacement is vertical deflection or slope. And what is force? In matrix method, force can be represented as normal force, F, or bending moment. Or bending moment. Okay. The force. The force. Basically, this is the generalized force, and this is the generalized displacement. So displacement, we can, based on the type of problem, based on the type of problem or the nature of the question, we can take vertical deflection as the displacement, delta. Delta displacement means always delta, okay? Pardon? Displacement means always delta. So delta can be vertical deflection or slope theta. Okay. So displacement can be vertical deflection or slope. And force can be normal force, that is normal point load or UTL, or bending. Okay. So take this down. If you have completed, then I will rub the board and I will go to the details. So this is very important. Flexibility means at any point or coordinate location. Coordinate location means what? In any structure, if I take a structure and if I put 10 points, if I locate on the beam, for example, this is a beam, okay? So this is a beam. I have taken 10 points. 10 points meaning 10 different coordinate location. 10 different points means 10 different location. Or 10 different position, those are called coordinate points. So at any point, coordinate location in any structure, that means at how much deflection or displacement is occurring due to unit force. I am putting a unit force, the force may be 1 kN, or the force may be 1 kN bending moment. Take this down. If you have completed, you can write in the chat box. That's it. Okay, so flexibility, which we have already learned, and just the opposite of flexibility is displacement. Okay, so today, since I'm focusing on flexibility, that is why I will not explain displacement today. On the next class, I will discuss displacement. Okay, so flavor of the force, basically what? So flexibility means how much displacement occurring due to unit force. I'm putting away the original, for example, on the beam which is coming, the original load, external load is coming on the beam. I am putting the load outside and I am putting unit load. And due to this unit load, what are the effects? Okay. So before that, so after this, we will learn the matrix. Now we have learned about flexibility. Now we will learn about how to, or what is the elements, or what are the important ingredients or components in a matrix. ओके, तो फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी ऑब्वियसली व्हेनेवर फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी मेथड इज देयर, आई टोल्ड यू दिस इज मैट्रिक्स मेथड, सो वी हैव टू नो द मैट्रिक्स. नाउ फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी मैट्रिक्स, flexibility matrix can be represented by this F, capital F or delta. In many books they are differently represented, but the usual representation is F, capital F or delta. Okay, and so another important, so this will be equals to a number of elements. Let us take delta 11, delta 12, delta 13, like this delta 1n, delta 21, delta 22, delta 23, like this delta 2n. So this is how the elements are put, are inserted in the matrix. Delta n. Okay. So we put the matrix like this. Like this in a matrix format. The matrix always, the flexibility matrix is always square matrix. N by n. If n is the number of coordinate direction, if n is the number of coordinate direction or location, coordinate direction or location, if we have n number of coordinate location, then the size of the matrix will be, always remember, the size of the matrix will be n by n. Always remember, if we have n by n matrix. So this is something like matrix. We have rows and we have columns, and the size of the matrix will be n by n. Okay, the size of the matrix is n by n. You can see here. Size of the matrix is n by n. Okay. And if we have n number of coordinates, for example, if we have 10 positions, for example, I have in my beam, I represent three locations, three points or three coordinates. Okay. So if it is three coordinates, then my matrix will be 3 by 2. Three rows and three columns. Always remember, if in flexibility method or stiffness method, the matrix, if we know the number of coordinates, the matrix will be square matrix, n by n. Okay. And these elements, all these elements in the matrix, obviously you all know from the matrix operation that these are called matrix elements. So all these delta 1, delta 2, all these are called elements of the matrix. Elements of the matrix also called, they are called flexibility coefficient. They are called flexibility coefficient. Flexibility coefficient. They are, these elements are called either elements of matrix from normal matrix operation, or it is called flexibility matrix. The elements of flexibility matrix are known as flexibility coefficient. So please write down flexibility coefficient.
please write down.
So the flexibility matrix, either it can be represented by capital F or delta. Delta is we represent delta because actually what we are calculating, we are calculating the displacement due to unit force. Now delta is we can represent this by delta, delta 11, delta 12, delta 13 like this, then delta 21, delta 31 like this. So the more the number of coordinates, please remember, more the number of coordinates, meaning for example, if you take a portal frame of three story, the more the number of more the complex the structure, more bigger the structure, more will be the points, and more the points, bigger will be the size of the matrix. More the number of points, bigger will be the size of the matrix. Okay. Mainly in our BTEC level, we can maximum have 3x3 matrix. Okay. Because more the size of the matrix, more it the complexity of calculation. Okay. But in practically, in computer softwares like StatPro, ETAP, SAT 2000, in all these softwares, they solve the structure using matrix method. They solve the structure using matrix. And all these elements which I was telling about flexibility coefficient. So delta, if I take delta I comma j. So delta I comma j is basically an element, a sample element, sample flexibility coefficient I'm taking, okay, flexibility coefficient. If I am representing the element of flexibility coefficient delta at position I comma j, means ith row jth column, that means ith row and jth column. At this point, so in terms of matrix, we will represent that it is in terms of just matrix. If I put this element in a matrix, let I equals to 2, j equals to 4. That means delta will be 2 comma 4. So it is ith row and jth column. So delta ij will be ith row and jth column. And but practically it will be represented as, when we will solve the problem, it will be displacement, it is a displacement at ith coordinate, displacement at ith coordinate occurred due to unit force at jth coordinate. So delta ij, whatever the position will be, for example, we can say if I equals to 3, j equals to 5, then delta will be what? 3 comma 5. So at 3 comma 5 location, I will put this value. But what is the physical meaning? The physical meaning from structural point of view, the meaning is delta ij, meaning what is the value of displacement at ith coordinate, at ith location, occurred due to unit force at jth coordinate. Please take this down. Please take this down. This is a very important concept in which we will use in our problem. Delta ij will be displacement at ith coordinate. For example, if you don't understand, let me show some example. Let me, I'm taking a beam.
am taking a beam, let me consider I am taking a statically indeterminate beam. Okay. Okay.
And in this beam, for example, this is my location one, this is location two, and location three. Okay. So now, what will be delta 1 2? Delta 1 2 will be displacement at one. This is delta 1 2. Displacement at one position due to unit load at two position. That means at location two. At location two, if I put unit load due to unit load at location two, what will be my effect at one? That is delta 1 2. I is one, j is two. That means I am putting a unit load at two. What is the effect at point one? I hope you can understand this. This is the most important tricky part in matrix method. This is the most important and tricky part in matrix method. That means delta 1 2 will be, what is the effect at one? What is the displacement at one due to unit load at two position? Again, if I take you delta 3 2, delta 3 2 will be what? What is the effect at three due to unit load at two? First number will be the effect, the position where effect is taking place. And the second number will be at that position I am putting the unit load. The unit load may be force, the unit load may be bending. So please take this down. So I hope this you have understood. I have taken a sample beam and I have represented what will be this, all these displacements. Now if question comes, for example, delta 2 2, delta 2 comma 2, then what will be, delta 2 2? Delta 2 comma 2 will be, what is the effect at two position? What is the effect at two position due to unit load at this position only? Two position. So if you have understood this, I hope those who have not understood, you can write in the chat box that sir, please explain. Basically, when we will solve the problem after this part, I will solve a problem using matrix method, flexibility method. There's a long procedure is there. This is just a way how to develop the matrix. How to develop the map? If you have taken down, you can write in the chat box. That's our done. Acha, my dear students, on next week, can you please write in the chat box what is your slot of Pooja ma'am's slot? When Pooja ma'am takes your class on Monday? Please tell me. Please write in the chat box when Professor Pooja Basu Chaudhary takes your class. Okay, Monday from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. Okay, this is the usual routine from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. Okay. So, ঠিক আছে, from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. I will take a class. Okay. Okay, on 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. on Monday. Okay, my dear students, from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. everyone have a light lunch on that day. I will take a class from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. ঠিক আছে? from 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. And I will communicate with you in the WhatsApp group that which slots are clear, because I want to complete the syllabus before next Friday. We have normal class on Friday, but before next Friday I want to clear the syllabus. So please inform me in my WhatsApp group that which are the slots during the morning, preferably during the morning, which are the slots in which you are free. Okay. Not now, later on. So you have taken down. So now I am rubbing this part. Okay. Okay. So now we will do a prompt. I hope everyone has submitted the assignment too. I will start grading from today only. I hope everyone has submitted assignment 2, and after I complete this chapter, the module 4 matrix method, I will again give you an assignment 3, which will be maybe of maximum 5 problems, 5 or 4 problems or 6 problems. 3 of flexibility, 3 of matrix method. Okay, and mind sure that maybe from December 1st week your classes might be starting. The college might be starting from December 1st week if the college reopens. In those classes there will be no theoretical class, only lab class. Okay, and make sure that this time you will have 70 marks long question paper. Okay, a full fledged 70 marks question paper, not online exam but offline exam. Okay, so be prepared. Whatever questions I have discussed on the board, whatever questions I have given in the assignment, those are enough. Okay,
question 1. The question is, analyze the frame analyze that, sorry, this is not frame, obviously we don't have frame in our syllabus. Analyze the continuous beam. First type of question, analyze the continuous beam.
So in structure analysis, I tell you every time that whenever you learn any design subject like RCC or structure analysis too, always learn step wise. If you learn step wise, it is very easy for you to keep installed in your brain also, and while solving or while practicing at home, it will be easy for you that after which step is there, previous step, successive steps, sequentially you can remember, sequentially you can memorize that what you are learning. Step-wise learning is very important, and it is easy for you only. In exam also, please write step-wise. Please solve all my question, whatever question I have discussed in my portion, solve step-wise. Okay.
So the question is, analyze the continuous beam using flexibility method. Analyze the continuous beam using flexibility method. Also, we have to draw the beam. Also, draw the beam detail. Bending moment.
Acha. My dear students, I missed out something. That is, one thing, make sure that flexibility method.
That flexibility or force method, under this method, whatever the methods are there, we should learn. So under flexibility method, we have learned this method, but we don't remember that these are all flexibility methods. So under flexibility or force method comes moment area method. moment area method we have learned in second year.
We have learned moment area method. So under this force method, this moment area method falls. The air under our moment area method thakbe.
Under this we have conjugate beam method. Conjugate beam method. Also we have Castiglione's method. MCQ comes in from this portion. Castiglione's method, unit load method, unit load method.
So these are the basic four methods which falls under force method.
Please take this down. So written down
under flexibility method, moment area method. So while solving any problem using flexibility method, either we can apply moment area method or conjugate beam method. These two methods we use to solve continuous beams,
to solve indeterminate continuous beams. In order to solve,
let me pardon. In order to solve indeterminate continuous beams, just wait. In order to solve indeterminate continuous beams, either we use moment area method or conjugate beam method, any one,
and Castiglione's method we apply for free. We apply Castiglione's method for free. Okay.
So please list it down. Okay. So under force method, please remember these are the force method, four method, moment area and conjugate beam to solve continuous beams. This we will apply to solve continuous beams.
To solve indeterminate continuous beams, we will use moment area method or conjugate beam method. And for Castiglione's method, to solve frames, we will use Castiglione's method. Okay.
So now let me. So you have taken down everyone, I hope.
Now let me show the problem. The problem is we have a two beam. We have a continuous beam of two spans. A. We have a A beam. We have AB and BC.
AB is 4 meter. And on AB, we have UDL of 60 kN per meter and a point load of 100 kN at midpoint of B and C. 1.5 meter, 1.5. Please take this down. So we have AB beam and BC at point X, 100 kN load is coming. We have been told the question is there. Analyze the continuous beam using flexibility method and also draw the bending moment diagram. Okay, so first step. So now we will go for the step wise. Okay. I told you, so step wise we will solve the problem. The first step,
we talk about the solution.
Okay, here we have points A, B, C. The coordinate locations, the coordinate locations, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, the positions or locations have not been shown here. We will decide which are the coordinate location or what are the positions we will do. For example, in many questions, you will see that the locations, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, like this, they are mentioned on the beam. In some question, I will give you that the locations are given on the beam. But here in this problem, no location is given, just told that we have to analyze the frame or analyze the continuous beam. So we ourselves have to decide at which point, at point A or B or C, what are the location number I will give. So coming to the step one is first calculate the degree of interment. Calculate DS. We have to calculate the degree of static indeterminacy DS. We have solved DS. Okay. So here DS we can learn. Here we have three, one unknown and one unknown. So DS will be what? Number of unknowns minus three static equation. Three static equilibrium equation. The number of unknowns is what? Three for fixed end plus one minus three. So degree of static indeterminacy is coming two. DS is coming two. I hope the video quality is good today. So the degree of indeterminacy, please make sure everyone try to learn from my class only, because afterwards it will be very difficult for you to understand, because these methods are not so easy. Step by step, if you understand here only and you solve one question by your own, then only you will be able to completely grasp or install the concept. So degree of static indeterminacy DS is number of unknown minus three static equilibrium equation. Why three static? Because it is a continuous beam only. a normal mean. So three equation, fx, fy and mz. So 3 plus 1 plus 1 minus 3, that is 2. So step 1 is calculation of degree of static equation. Okay. So therefore, 2 is unknown. We have 2 unknowns. So therefore, 2 unknowns. 2 unknowns means here I have to draw, see what is the requirement of the problem. The requirement of the problem is draw the bending moment diagram. So 2 unknowns, we can put moment at A unknown and moment at B unknown, because we know that moment at C is zero. At C we have roller support at the end. At this point we have roller support at the end. So we always know that for a simply supported end at free end, the bending moment is zero. So from here we can write down that the